हेलो हेलो, इज माय ऑडियो अवेलेबल टू ऑल? ओके ओके, लेट मी जस्ट गो थ्रू द स्लाइड्स अगेन, जस्ट अ मिनट. सो द प्रेजेंटेशन टुडे, इट विल फोकस ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन, बेसिक डॉक्यूमेंट क्रिएशन एंड टेक्स्ट फॉर्मेटिंग, राइट? सो let me first tell you what is LaTeX all about, the introduction part. Now LaTeX is a document preparation system for producing professional looking documents, and it is not a word processor. It is particularly suited to produce long structured documents, and it is very good at typesetting equations. It is available as a free software for most operating systems. LaTeX is based on TeX, a typesetting system designed by Donald E. Kundt in 1978 for high-quality digital typesetting. Now, in 1978, a computer scientist by the name of Donald E. Kundt, he grew frustrated with the mistakes that his publisher made in typesetting his work. He decided to create a typesetting program that everyone could easily use to typeset the documents, and made it freely available. So the result was TeX, and this was the scientist who discovered TeX. Now TeX is a low-level language that computers can work with, but most people would find it difficult to use. So LaTeX was developed to make it easier. A mathematician and computer scientist, Leslie Lamport, wrote a variant of TeX called LaTeX. Now, how is it different from Word? If you are used to produce documents with Microsoft Word, you will find LaTeX a difficult style of working. But believe me, by the end of the FDP, you will prefer LaTeX over Microsoft Word. A LaTeX document is a plain text file with a .tex file extension, so it can be typed in a LaTeX editor. When the document is finished, you compile it. This means converting it into another format. Several different output formats are available, but probably the most useful is the portable document format. So in the next few slides, I'll talk about all these points, right? So now let's go to the second section, that is the basic document creation. Now, what are the mandatory requirements for a LaTeX document? So there are three components that are essential for a LaTeX document. The first one is backslash document class, and in curly braces I've written article. Article means the class that I'm talking about. Throughout this FDB, we are going to focus on research documents, so the class will always be article. Then the second crucial component is backslash begin document, and the third one is backslash end document. So you can see these are the commands in the LaTeX, and every command is starting with a backslash symbol. So there are two slashes in your keyboard. One is backslash and the other one is front slash, right? So you will always focus, while we are doing in LaTeX, we will focus on the backslash command. Now, and whatever commands we are going to write, they have to be included in the curly braces, right? So one important thing is backslash, and the second important thing is curly braces, right? Okay. So the first statement, it tells you what kind of document we are going to process. And since we are processing on research documents, so every time we are going to write here article. There are different classes also, I will tell you later on. Now, before class, in the previous slide, I had written here article. So before article, this word, I'm writing here in square brackets options. So this is completely optional. You can give, you may omit also. There is no harm in it, right? Now, so whenever we are going to provide options from our side, we will always enclose this in square bracket. And whatever is mandatory, that has to be put in curly braces. Now, what are all the different values of classes that we can choose? Now, suppose if we are writing on a book, then we will write the class as book. If we are writing report, we will write here report. If we are writing a research paper, we will write here article. If we are writing a letter, we are going to write here letter. So we will basically focus on the article, right? Okay. Now, so this is a small syntax of a LaTeX source file. You can see I've written here document class options. I haven't included any options here. And I'm writing class. Then I'm writing preamble. What is preamble? I will let you know. And then I've written begin document, end document. And whatever document, body of the document is to be written between begin document and end document. So here you can see a minimal LaTeX file. Document class article, begin document and end document. In between I'm writing life is beautiful, right? So whatever you write after end document, that will not be executed in LaTeX. So this has to be the end line in your LaTeX source file. Clear? Okay. Then all the necessary information, it has to be included in curly braces, I told you. And all the optional information, that has to be enclosed in square brackets. So let's take an example. You can see that I've written document class 11 point article. So 11 point is optional. Otherwise, by default, 10 point size is used. So if I want to increase the point size to 11, that is the option given from my end. Similarly, I've used the font size as 12 points. I'm writing in the option as 12 point, right? Okay. So whenever your source file starts, the first line in your source code should be document class article. Okay. Let's look at the screenshot. So this is how you prepare a new document in a file. The ones who have downloaded LaTeX, so you will find that there are two software packages I told you to download. One is the MikTeX and the second one is TeXstudio. So MikTeX is the parent file which contains all the commands and it is stored in your C drive. While when you download TeXstudio, the screenshot, you can always place the shortcut on your desktop. So in TeXstudio, it is the editor part. So whatever we are going to write, we will write in TeXstudio. So on your desktops, you can right click your TeXstudio, it will open. And this is the page that it will show. So you will go to the file option, you can see here. And when you click your file option, a drop down menu will be presented. And from there, you will choose new file. Or you can choose it from here also. You can see that there is a white page shown and a plus symbol shown here. If you click this, a blank page is shown here, right? And the name of that blank page will be untitled because we haven't saved this file. Now, as I told you in the previous slide, the first line in my source code will be backslash document class altogether. And there is no space here. And then I'm enclosing article in curly braces. This is my research papers. I'm writing article here. Then in the next line, I'm writing backslash begin document. And then I'm writing the body of my document as welcome to today's webinar on LaTeX, an art of writing research manuscript. And then I want to end my document. So the last line in my source code is backslash end document, right? Okay. Now the next step after writing the blank page, I have to save this file. So I will go again to the file menu. I will click it. This drop-down menu is shown. And you can see that the save option is shown here. So you will click the save option. After clicking the save option, it will ask you where to save it. So it is always advised to save the source code in a separate folder because when you execute this file, along with this basic file, many other files are also generated. So if you don't keep it in a folder, your desktop will get covered with all the extra files, right? So I have chosen my desktop and I've created a folder as LaTeX webinar and I'm giving the name, the file name as document one, and then I will save it, right? So once I click the save button, earlier the document was written with the name untitled.txt. Now I've saved it with the name document one. So the name is now document one and you can see that the extension here is .tex. So all your LaTeX files are stored with this extension, right? Then the next thing. So this is how you saved your file. Now I want to show its output also. This is the source code, right? Now how to check the output? Here, again in this menu, You can see there are two green buttons. One is a single green button, and then there are two green buttons here. So when you press the single green button, the triangular shape, it means it will only compile. Compile means when you compile this, it will tell you, is it correctly written or there are some errors. So when I compile it, if there are some errors here, suppose you forget to put curly braces here and you put here square brackets, here at the bottom, it will show you that error. It will mark that line and it will show you that error. Suppose you wrote begin document, but you forgot to wrote end document. So again, when you compile it, it will show you the error. Compile will not show you the output, but it will only show you the error, right? And then if I click onto the second button means build and view. So it will build also, it will show you the errors, or if there is no error, it will show you this statement that process exited normally, right? And on your right hand side, you can see the PDF version of your file. It is showing welcome to today's webinar on LaTeX and Art of Writing Research Manuscript, right? So whatever I've written between begin document and end document, that is being shown in the output, right? So, and since there is no error here, so it is telling me process exited normally, clear? So if there are some errors, it will be shown here, right? Okay. Now there are certain checkpoints for LaTeX processing procedure. The first one is commands for LaTeX that will affect the whole document should be included in the preamble. Now, let me tell you what is preamble. Preamble is anything that you write between the first line, that is document class, and between the second line, that is begin document. Whatever you write in between this, that is known as preamble. And whatever you write in the preamble, that is implemented to the whole body of your document, right? So that this point will come to know in the later slides. Okay. Body of the document where text is included must occur between begin document and end document commands. Use a text editor to write the source file. The contents of the source file should be plain ASCII characters only. Any text that comes after the end document command will be ignored, and run LaTeX on the source file to get the output file, right? So whenever you're running a source file, that should be opened, right? And then you will get the output file. And during the processing, some other files are also generated with the extensions .aux, .log, and so on. So I have a screenshot. So when I save that file with the name document1, you can see that in the type document1, it is showing you the LaTeX document, right? This is the type. So this is my source code. Along with it, there are four more files created. Among this, the useful file is document one. You can see that this is a PDF file. So whenever you send your research papers for checking or to your guides, you never send the source code. You always send the PDF version, right? So the source code is kept with you. So any changes you are authorized to do, nobody else is authorized to do, right? But along with the files, you can see there are three more files that are generated. So that was the only logic of telling you to create this file in a separate folder. So the more amount of LaTeX files you create, that many files are generated in your folder, right? Okay. Next, what are error messages? LaTeX will tell you when it figures out that something is wrong. So I told you that in the bottom, if there is something wrong in your LaTeX file, so it will tell you. Common error is not to close braces for a command. So one common error that we commit is that we forget to, suppose we have started the braces, but we forget to end the braces, or we are writing a command without enclosing them in braces. So curly braces are very important. Another frequent error is to use max command outside of the max mode. This I'll tell you in my second or third session maybe, right? Okay. Next is standard class options. Now, if you remember that I told you that whenever options are to be given from your end, they have to be enclosed in square brackets. So what all those options can be? So those options can be font sizes, it can be paper size and format, it can be multiple column, it can be title page behavior. So let us first focus on font sizes. Now LaTeX knows three font sizes. that is 10 point, that is by default 11 point, 12 point. So 10 point you don't have to mention, 11 point and 12 point, they are, if you want your article to be written in these two font sizes, then you have to give it, give this an option. How to give this an option, I'll tell you after I explain this. Other global and local font sizes are also available through various packages. So this is an example. You can see this is 10 point size, this is 11 point size, and this is 12 point size. Okay. So this is about the font sizes. The next class option is paper size and format. Now we have different sizes of paper available with us. So what are all those different sizes worldwide? It is A4 paper by default. You don't have to mention it. Then we have letter paper. We have A5 paper, B5 paper, executive paper, legal paper, right? So suppose you're working with MS Word, then suppose you want your printout in a letter paper or maybe in a legal paper. So you have to yourself mark up all these settings, right? Nobody else is going to make these settings. So if you're working with the A4 size, the settings are different. If it, you're working in a legal size paper, the settings are different. So all that has to be done manually, whosoever is the user. But when you do it in LaTeX, it becomes very comfortable in the options by simply writing the type of paper or the paper size. LaTeX itself will design the format, right? The settings will be itself done, right? So you can see that these are a few of the sizes that I talked about. Okay. Now, next class option is multiple column. You might have seen that sometimes when you submit your research papers, they want the article to be written in two column form, right? Sometimes it may be one column form also. So there are two types of multiple columns. One is one column and two column. One column is the default and the second one is two column. So by default, text is always written in a single column. So if you want your article to be written in two column, you have to mention this in the option. So this is an example that when your article is written in two column, how it looks like, right? Okay. Then we have the next one is the title page behavior. That is very, very important. So what is title page behavior? Now, whenever you're writing a research report or anything or a research paper, the first thing in your research paper is the title page, right? So there are two types of title page behavior. One is no title page, default for an article, right? And the other one is title page default for reports and books. Now, what is the meaning of no title page and title page? Now, suppose you give the command no title page, then what will happen? The title and the body of the document, they will be together displayed on the same page. Like you can see here in this example, this is my title and the document, the body of the document, they are together displayed on the same page. But if I give the command title page in the options, this title will be displayed on my first page, and the body of the document will be shifted to the next page. So the first page will only be the title page. So that is only in case of reports and books. So if you are writing a research paper, the abstract and the title of your manuscript, they together start from the same page. So whenever we are working for an article, that is if the class mentioned this article, we don't have to give this. No title page is not required. It is by default. And if I'm writing for a report or a book, then by default, this setting is done. But if I'm doing it, suppose I want a title page in my article, then I have to give in the options as title page, right? Now, the next thing that you should keep in mind, how to execute the title page, right? So you have to use the command make title. So I will tell you about how to write this command and where you need to place this command in the next slides. So just remember that to execute your title, we need the command backslash make title, and there is no space between make and title, right? Okay. Next is page numbering, the next important thing, right? Page numbering and headings. Now for page numberings and headings, the command used is backslash page style, and then whatever style you want to use, we have to mention it here. And then another important thing is where we need to place these commands. So it should always go between document class article and begin document. That means this has to be placed in the preamble. It will be applied to the whole article, I told you in the beginning that whatever you are going to write in the preamble, that will be applied for the whole document, right? Now, what all style options are available with us? So in place of style, if I write plain, it is the default settings. It puts the page number at the center of the bottom of the page and provides no headings. So what happens when you use this command? Your page number will be displayed at the center of the page and towards the bottom of the page, and there will be no headings provided, right? This is the first style option. The second style option is page style empty. Now it provides neither page number nor the headings. So if I don't want page numbers, and that is very seldom used, so if I don't want them, so I will use the style as empty. And the third style option is headings. So this will provide page numbers and headings from any sections that you are using. Suppose you are working in page numbering section, so it will give the page numbering section at the top right, and it will also provide the page number, right? Okay. So for page numberings and headings, the command used is backslash page style, and then in brackets you will write whether you want to use plain, whether you want to use empty, or whether you want to use the headings as the option, right? Okay. Next is page numbering. For page numbering also, if you want different numbering styles on your page, what all numbering styles are available? So the command used is backslash page numbering without any space, and you write the numbering style here. Now, what are all the numbering styles? The first numbering style is Arabic. So if you write in place of num style as Arabic, it will give you the Arabic numerals. So the page will start with the page counter number as 1, right? The second one is Roman. So if I write Roman in small letters, so when I execute this command in the page numbering, I will get my numbers as lowercase Roman numerals. Similarly, if I use Roman and I put the capital R here, it will show me uppercase Roman numerals. Likewise, if I use ALPH, small ALPH, it will give me lowercase letters. And if I write capital ALPH, it will give me uppercase letters. So these are all the num styles: Arabic, Roman, capital Roman, ALPH, and capital ALPH. And you have to use the command page numbering, and you write the number style here, right? Okay. Now let's create a title page, the very, very important part of your research manuscript. So what are all the commands? The commands are title. So you will write the command as backslash title, and you will write your title here. Then it is backslash author. Suppose there is only one author in your article, you will write backslash author, and then you write the date. I will tell you how to write this date in your LaTeX editor, right? Now, I told you that if you want to execute the title, which command is to be used? We have to use backslash make title. And it has to be placed immediately after the begin document. So you should know where you need to place these commands. If you place these commands at the wrong positions, LaTeX will always give you an error message when you compile it, right? So this has to be placed after begin document. And then if the command backslash date is omitted, the current date is printed automatically below the author's entries on the title page. This I'll tell you in details in the next few slides. Okay. So till here, just remember that for title, we will use the command backslash title, and in curly braces, we will write down the title. Then we will write backslash author. In curly braces, you'll write your name. And then to exhibit the date, we will write backslash date. And to execute all this, we have to use the command backslash make title. And it will be placed immediately after the begin document command, right? Now, look at the screenshot. Look at the left part of the LaTeX editor. I'm writing the first statement as backslash document class article, right? Then I'm writing backslash title. I'm giving the title of my page as webinar on LaTeX. Then I'm writing author. Backslash author, and I'm writing my name, and then I'm writing backslash date. I'm writing a date as 21st to 24th April 2020. And then After writing these three things, I am writing / begin document. Then in the last slide, I told you where you have to place make title command. It has to be placed immediately after begin document. And then I'm writing a body of the document. I'm writing a paragraph. And then I've ended it as / end document, right? So when I compile this and build my preview, I will see that my preview looks like this. Webinar on LaTeX, this was the title of my article. Then the author name is written here. The date is mentioned here. And whatever body I've written, that is being displayed here, right? See, isn't it simple? I did no settings on my end. You can see that the title has been shown in a bigger font size. Then everything is displayed in a beautiful manner, right? And if you want to write this article in Word, you have to do the settings on your own, right? Yep. So this was creating a title page. Now, suppose if I don't want to create the title page with date, suppose I forget to write the date command, right? So in the previous slide, you can see that I had written here date. Now, before that date command, I'm putting a percentage symbol. So percentage symbol marks that you are commenting this statement and you don't want LaTeX to execute this line, right? So whenever you put a percentage symbol in front of any command, it will be highlighted like this and it will show, it means that you are commenting that statement and you don't want LaTeX to compile it, right? And then you can see that when I have compiled this article, I am being shown the date April 19, 2020. Now I am being shown this date because I was preparing this document on 19th April. That means if I execute this command right now, it will show me today's date, right? So if you forget to write the date option, so it will always produce today's date, right? But sometimes you don't want the date to be written there. Then what is to be done? Then if you want that, you want to remove the date, what will you do? You will write / date and you will simply put curly braces. You won't write anything inside the curly braces, right? So now when I compile this document, I can see that on my PDF, the date is not mentioned, right? So this is how the date command is used. So I'll just repeat all the three slides again. If you write, suppose I want to present my article on, suppose 1st May, right? So what will I write? I will give my date as 1st May 2020. So automatically when I compile this, the date will be shown as 1st May, right? But if I don't want the date, if I just want that today's date should be displayed, so I will not write only the date command. So if I don't write the date command, automatically by default, today's date will be displayed. And if I don't want the date to be displayed, I will simply write / date and I'll put open curly braces. I hope it is clear. Okay. Now, for two column option, like I told you in my previous slides, if I want that this article should be written in the previous slide, you can see that there is only one column. Now, suppose if I want my article to be written in two column form, then what is to be done? I have to give in the options. If you remember, before article in square brackets, I have to give the option two column, right? Now, when I compile it, you can see that the data is written in two column form. Clear? Okay. Now, and then page numbering, I also told you. In page numbering, it has to be put in the preamble part. So what is the preamble? I'm again repeating. Whatever you write between the first line, that is document class, and begin document, that is the preamble. So since I want my page numbering to be focused on all the pages of my document, so I have to write it in the preamble. And how to write it? I'm writing / page numbering and I'm writing the numbering style as Roman. Capital R is being used. So in the display, you can see that capital one is being written here, right? Capital Roman numeral one is written here, right? Likewise, in the second page, 2, 3, like that, it will be displayed. Right. You can also change this to Arabic. You can change this to Alf. You can change this to small Roman. You can do any style, right, on your own. Okay. Now, Let me show you this in a LaTeX editor. Let me share the screen with you all. Just a second. Okay. Look at this editor screen. You can see that I've written the first line of my document as document class article. Then I'm writing / title webinar on LaTeX, the things that I just explained to you. And then I'm writing author, my name, and then I'm writing the date. Suppose I write here the date as 23 April, right? And then I'm writing begin document. Then I want my title to be displayed, so I want make title. And then I'm writing the body of the document here, and then I'm ending the document, right? Now let me execute it. You can see there is a two green buttons here for build and view. When I execute this, it takes a few fraction of seconds. And you can see that the display is seen on the right hand side. So you can see that the date is 23rd April now, when I mention it, right? Now suppose if I put a comment here, and then if I execute this, still the date is shown as April 23, right? So by default also, if I forget to write the command as date, it will by default show me the date. Now suppose if I want my date to be shown, if I don't want my date to be shown, you can see that I'm just writing open curly braces, and when I execute it, the date is removed, right? Okay. So you can see that this is my LaTeX editor. This is the PDF view shown, and this is where the error is shown. So now since there are no errors, so it is showing me process exited normally, right? Okay. Now let me go back to the slide screen. Okay. Then the next important thing is, so till now we have seen how to create the title page. Now let's talk about the body of the document. Now in the body, you have always seen that there are different sections in your body. You never write your article in one go. So there is an abstract, there is an introduction, then there is a literature review section, then you have a methodology section, then you tell about your experimental results, there is a result and discussion section, and then you conclude your answer, right? So how to go about all these sections in LaTeX? So if we are talking about book, a book never has section, it has always chapter. So there will be chapters, right? If I'm talking about an article, it will always have section. And then you can see that suppose your methodology section has, inside that section, there are another sections inside it, right? Suppose the third section is your methodology, then you have 3.1, 3.2, then there are subsections inside it. So how to do them? We use the command subsection, then we have subsection. Then also to change a paragraph, we have the command paragraph, subparagraph also. So there is a sectional hierarchy. So we always start from the highest and then we move on to the lowest one, right? So whenever we are talking about books or report, your highest sectioning level is chapter. And whenever we talk about article, it is always section, right? So we will just talk about this in detail. Okay. Now let's look at this screenshot. So I have divided my article into four sections. So you can see the output here. There is introduction, there is methodology, there is results and discussion, and then there is conclusions, right? So how have I made it? Let's go back to the source editor. So the same things are written here: document class, article, title, author, date, and then I've begin my document, and then I've also written make title. Now suppose I want to make my first section. This paragraph is my first section. So before the starting of the first paragraph, I will give the command / section. And inside the curly braces, I have to give the name of the section. So it will be introduction, right? Then the second paragraph starts from here, and the name of my second paragraph is methodology. So before the second paragraph begins, I'm writing the command backslash section, and I'm giving the command methodology. Then the third section is results and discussion. So I'm writing backslash section, results and discussion. And then the fourth one is conclusions. So I'm giving the command backslash section, and I'm writing the name as conclusions, right? When I compile this, I will get the PDF view as like this. So one major change you can see here, that while I was marking the sections, I never marked 1, 2, 3, and 4. It is automatically being displayed by LaTeX, right? So the same thing, if you're working in Microsoft Word, you have to write all these manually on your own, right? And somehow, suppose you forget to write a section in between. So if you in LaTeX, if you insert it, automatically these numbers will change, right? But while you are working in Microsoft Word, every change that you do, you have to do it on your own. Suppose after writing this whole article, I forget to write one paragraph, and that section has to be included between introduction and methodology. So when I write in LaTeX, what happens? Automatically, methodology will become my third section, this will become my fourth section, and this will become my fifth section. I don't have to do anything. But if I have to work in Microsoft Word, all these numberings I have to change on my own. It will not be done by Microsoft Word, right? So this is the advantage. I told you that side by side throughout my session, I'll tell you about the disadvantages of Word and why is LaTeX preferable to use than Microsoft Word, right? Okay. So now let me show you my LaTeX editor screen. Let me share that screen with you. Okay. So the same thing I'll show you here. So you can see that these are the things that was already written. I have divided the entire article into the sections, that is introduction, then methodology, and then results and discussion, and then conclusion, right? Now when I take the, when I compile it, you can see here that how beautifully LaTeX compiles my document, right? Now suppose I want my methodology to be written before introduction. Let me just give you an example. The thing that I was just explaining before. Suppose I changed my methodology and introduction sections, right? Now when I compile it, can you see that the numbering was also automatically done? Likewise, suppose I add one section here. Let me add the section and give it the name experimental data. Now let me execute it. Can you see again the numbering was automatically done, right? So you can see how beautifully LaTeX works. And the same thing if you have to do in Microsoft Word, all these manipulations have to be done on your own, right? So now I think that you will prefer LaTeX over Microsoft Word, right? Okay. Let me go back to my slides. Okay. So I told you about the sections. Now, okay. Now suppose then after you convert your document into different section, what is the next important thing? If you're writing a report, suppose you want an index page also, isn't it? And how fussy it becomes when you work in Microsoft Word. You have to give it a serial number. You have to write all the topics. You have to give the concern page numbers along with it. But and somehow suppose you forget to write something inside the document and later on you remember and you add it on, you have to change it again and again and again. The index page has to change again and again according to different page numbers, right? So there is a very beautiful method here, what it is. Now suppose we saw how to give the section command, backslash section, Again, you can see there is a square bracket here written as short title. This is an option you may omit it, but the main, suppose in my document I want to exhibit the name of my first section as introduction, but I want that in the table of contents in the index page, I don't want to display the name as introduction, I want to display intro, I want a short name for it. So what will I do? In the short title, I will write the name intro, and in the title, I will write the introduction name, right? So in the document, when I execute it, in the document, it will give me the whole name as introduction, but in the table of contents, it will release the name as intro, right? And somehow, if I don't want that a particular section should be marked, for example, in bibliography, when we write a bibliography, that section is not marked, right? Or when we write acknowledgement, that section is not marked. So if I don't want that section to be numbered by LaTeX, I have to give the command backslash section star. So when I put a section star, it will not give the number to that section, right? Okay. Let us look at this example. So in my document, if I give the name workshop on LaTeX, so that particular section in the document will be shown as workshop on LaTeX, but in the table of contents, it will be generated as LaTeX only, right? So this is an option. It is not mandatory that you have to use a short title. In many times, the same title is written on the table of contents, right? Now, how the table of contents is to be generated? The table of contents are to be generated with the help of the command backslash table of contents, right? Okay. Now let's go to this section, table of contents. Now, where is the table of contents to be written? Again, the main important thing. Place the command table of contents after your begin document. So after begin document, you are already placing the command backslash make title. After backslash make title, you will give the command backslash table of contents. So when you give this command backslash table of contents, automatically on your PDF, when you execute it, the table of contents will be generated there, right? Okay, let's see. Look at the screenshot. See, I have written four sections. These are introduction, methodology, and then results and discussions, and the final section is conclusions, right? But in the introduction section, I have given the short name as intro. In methodology section, I have given the name method. In results and discussion section, I have given the name R&D. And conclusion, I have not given any option here, right? And after begin document, I have given make title to display this title, and I have given backslash table of contents. Now, when I compile it, on the right hand side, you can see that in the contents, all the short names have been given that I have mentioned. Conclusion wasn't given any short name, so it is written as such. But in the document, the main title is given, right? Okay. So let me show you with the help of the LaTeX editor again. Let me share my screen. Okay. So this was my LaTeX document editor. So after make title command, if I write table of contents, and when I execute this, you can see that the table of contents are automatically marked by LaTeX. And you can see that neither the serial numbers I gave, neither these topics I mentioned here, neither these page numbers I mentioned. So you can see that my conclusion is moving on to the second page. So results and discussion conclusions are moving to the second page. So automatically the page numbers are marked there, right? Now, suppose I want the title page to be displayed on a different page. So if you remember the few slides before the article, I will give here the command title page, and this is an option. So I will write here title page, and now when I execute it, you can see that the title page is shifted to the next one, right? The title page is shifted to the first page and the entire body of the document is shifted to the second page onwards. Right? Okay. So you got a basic idea how the LaTeX editor works. And if I don't give this command title page, it will show the title along with the document on the same very page. Clear? Okay. Now, likewise, if I change this section and if I make this as my first section, let me make the introduction section as the first section. So you can see that everything in the table of contents will also change accordingly. See, can you see? Introduction was changed. First section became introduction, second section became methodology, and in the contents also these sections automatically changed, right? And you can just analyze that if you were doing this in Word, you have to do it all on your own, right? Okay, so let me go back to my slides. Okay, so table of contents, I told you. A quick question. Okay, so let me launch the question. Hurry up, mark the options. Okay, so let me close the question. So many of you have marked it correctly. Yes, the answer is curly braces. So this you should keep in mind. And then the next question. Mark the option. Okay, so let me close the question. So the correct option is the first one. You always place the command make title between begin document and end document. Okay. So we move on to the last section for today, that is text formatting. In text formatting, now sometimes you see that some part of your text is written in bullet forms, right? Now how to write it in bullet form? So bullet form means that you are giving a different environment to that particular text. So how will you write it? The environment used is begin itemize and you end your article, that part with the help of end itemize. And every item should start with the command backslash item. Suppose I want to write these five lines in bulleted form. So before the line starts, I will write begin itemize. And at the end of the last line, I will write it as end itemize. And in between the beginning of every line, I have to give the command backslash item, right? When I execute it, the output will be shown in this way, right? So for bulleted environment, I have to use the command as itemize. And I have to begin that environment and I have to end that environment also. And then we have for numbering. Now, sometimes some part is written in bulleted form. Sometimes it is also written in numbered form. So to write it in a numbered form, the method is same, only the environment changes. There we were writing itemize, now we will write that as enumerate. So we will write begin enumerate and end enumerate. So you can again see that these five lines were to be written in a numbered list form. So I have written begin enumerate in the beginning and I have written end enumerate in the end. And before the beginning of every line, I have written backslash item. Right? And when I check the output, I can see that the list has been changed to a numbered list. Clear? Okay. So with this, I end my session. You can just reach out to me at my email address, tanya.bose@chitkara.edu.in. So your doubts will be answered in my next session. And before I end, I just would like to thank Dr. Mohit Kumar Kakkar, Assistant Dean, Department of Applied Sciences, for taking this initiative and encouraging me to organize this live FDP. I would also like to thank the IT department for providing their valuable support and bringing all of us together on this platform. And we got an overwhelming response and around 118 participants from various schools of Chitkara University as well as outside Chitkara University had registered for this FDP. So in the morning when I was taking the poll, I don't know if you were able to hear me or not, there was some problem in the internet connection. So around 92% were from Chitkara and there were 8% who were outside Chitkara. And then there were 81% faculty members, 8% PhD students and 11% as graduate as well as postgraduate students. So we had a mix of audience. So there I end. So till then, take care. I'll see you tomorrow at the same time. Thank you.